सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। Wanted to do some Shanti mantras as well. Forgot, let's do those as well. ओम शन्नो मित्र शंवरुणः शन्नो भवत्वर्यमा शन्न इंद्रो बृहस्पतिः शन्नो विष्णुरुक्रमः नमो ब्रह्मणे नमस्ते वायो त्वमेव प्रत्यक्षं ब्रह्मासि त्वमेव प्रत्यक्षं ब्रह्म वदिष्यामि ऋतं वदिष्यामि सत्यं वदिष्यामि तन्मामवतु तद्वक्तारमवतु भवतु मामवतु वक्तारम्। ओम शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ॐ यश्छन्दसा वृषभो विश्वरूपः छन्दोऽभ्योऽध्यमृता आसंबभूव समेन्द्रो मेधया आस्पृणोतु अमृतस्य देवधारणो भूयासं शरीरं मे विचर्षणं जिह्वा मे वदुमत्तमा कर्णा आभ्यां भूरि विश्वं ब्रह्मणकोशोऽसि मेधया पिहितः श्रुतं मे गोपाय। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ॐ अहम वृक्षस्यरेरिवा कीर्तिःपृष्ठङ्गिरेरिवा ऊर्ध्वपवित्रो भाजिनीव स्मृतमस्मि द्रविणगुं सवर्चसं सुमेधामृतोक्षितः इति त्रिशङ्कोर्भेदानुवचनम्। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ॐ आप्यायन्तु अमाङ्गानि वाक्प्राणश्चक्षुश्रोत्रमथो बलमिन्द्रियाणि च सर्वाणि सर्वं ब्रह्म उपनिषदं माहं ब्रह्म निराकुर्यां मा ब्रह्म निराकरोध निराकरणमस्तु निराकरणं म्यस्तु तदात्मनि निरतेय उपनिषत्सु धर्मास्ते मयि सन्तु ते मयि सन्तु। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ॐ वाङ्मे मनसि प्रतिष्ठिता मनो मे वाचि प्रतिष्ठितं महावीरवीर्मेधि वेदस्य वाणी स्तः श्रुतं मे मा प्रहासीहि अनेनाधीतेन अहोरात्रां सन्नधामि ऋतं वदिष्यामि सत्यं वदिष्यामि तन्मामवतु तद्वक्तारमवतु भवतु मामवतु वक्तारम् अवतु वक्तारम्। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ॐ भद्रन्नो अपि वातय मनः। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ॐ भद्रं कर्णे विश्रणयाम देवाः भद्रं पश्येमाक्षभिर्यजत्राः स्थिरैरङ्गैः सुष्ठुवागुंसस्तनूभिः यशेम देवहितं यदायुः स्वस्ति न इन्द्रो वृद्धश्रवाः स्वस्ति नः पूषा विश्ववेदाः स्वस्ति नस्तार्क्ष्यो वरिष्ठनेमिः स्वस्ति नो बृहस्पतिर्दधातु। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ॐ यो ब्रह्माणं विदधाति पूर्वं यो वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुंह देवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ॐ नमो ब्रह्मादिभ्यो ब्रह्मविद्यासम्प्रदायकर्तृभ्यो वंशऋषिभ्यो महद्भ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः सर्वोपप्लवरहितः प्रज्ञारघनः प्रत्यगर्थो ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि। ॐ नारायणं पद्मभुवं वसिष्ठं शक्तिं च पुत्र पराशरं च व्यासं शुकं गौडपदं महान्तं श्रीगोविन्दयोगीन्द्रमथास्य शिष्यम्। ओके सो in the earlier parthas we had a lot of hiccups, so at least in the first partha I thought we'll do Dashashanti mantra, and every day we'll chant the regular prayers with the first Mangalacharana shloka of Bhashyaratna Prabha and Purnanandi also the first one. I'll prefer as and when possible. So I'll not give enough, you know, a lot of background to this. I'm sure that most of you know what Brahma Sutra is and what Adhyasa Bhashya is even. So anyway, as a brief introduction, Brahma Sutra is part of Prasthanatraya. Prasthana means when one wants to give up this samsara completely and walk away from samsara of rebirths. One does not want to go through this dukkha rupa samsara, then one is supposed to study the Prasthanatraya, the triad. And the triad, the Traya, is Shruti Prasthana in the form of Upanishads, the Smriti Prasthana in the form of Bhagavad Gita, and Nyaya Prasthana, which involves Tarka, in the form of Brahma Sutra. In fact, Bhagavan Bhashyakara, Shankaracharya, is called as Bhashyakara because of this reason, that he wrote Bhashya on the Sutras, not because he wrote the Bhashya on the Upanishads and Gita, because Bhashya technically means on Sutra. And the style is in keeping with the style of Mahabhashya on Vyakarana by Patanjali Maharshi. So those who know how the style of Mahabhashya is, they praise Bhagavan Shankaracharya, Bhashyakara, as following that style, and his Bhashya also being Prasanna Gambhira. So it is very pleasing to study and it has a great depth. Now this great depth of the Bhashya on the Brahma Sutras extends to the Upanishads and the Bhagavad Gita Bhashya. Therefore, by extension, they are called as Bhashyas. And since it has such a depth, therefore, there are multiple Vyakhyanas, Tikas on these. Bhagavan Anandagiri wrote Tika on all of these. Therefore, he gets the name as Tikakara in the Sampradaya. But there are other Vyakhyanas specifically on some parts. For example, on Brahma Sutra, there is a Sampradaya which divides itself into Vivarna and Bhamati. So Bhamati is created by Bhagavan Vachaspati Mishra, who wrote Vyakhyanas on all darshanas, all Astika darshanas. So great personality. And Bhamati is a little terse. So jokingly, it is said that when Bhamatikara wrote Bhamati, that time when he presented it to the Vidwat Sabha, they didn't understand it. It was even beyond the capacity of the entire Sabha. So they, you know, whether it's a joke or not, but it runs in the Sampradaya, they said that the Bhamatikara Vachaswati Mishra should be fed the ghee made of the buffalo milk. So that makes a person jada, so it can, you know, it can be watered down. The Vyakhyana can be watered down so that at least the Vidwat Sabha understands it. And then it is said that he, you know, rewrote parts or something. This is what is mentioned. So that is the Bhamati Sampradaya, where Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasana, all three are considered as way to moksha, just like it is in Vivarana Sampradaya, which Sringeri and the other Chaturamna Mathas follow. But primary importance as to what is the exact cause of moksha is given to Nididhyasana. Whereas in Vivarana Sampradaya, the primary importance as the direct cause of moksha is said to be Shravana. Shravana of the Shruti Mantras, which are pervading through the Smritis, Puranas, Itihasas, all through in Prakarna Granthas and in translations even. So Shravana is the main cause for moksha as per the core Sampradaya of Chaturamna Mathas. And the Tikas are either based on Bhamati or they are based on Vivarana Sampradaya. So in Vivarana Sampradaya you have Bhashyaratna Prabha made by Bhagavan Ramananda Yati, whose Tika is more elaborate and it is simpler in comparison to the Tikas which existed earlier, which are terse, which are in the Vivarana Sampradaya itself. You have Nyaya Nidaya by Bhagavan
टीकाकारा आनंदगिरी विच इज ऑल्सो टर्स इन कंपेरिजन टू भाष्यरत्न प्रभा. सो दिस व्याख्या ऑन दी भाष्यरत्न प्रभा भाष्यरत्न प्रभा दिस व्याख्या ऑन दी भाष्य विच इट्सेल्फ इज कंसिडर्ड एज रत्न. सो भाष्यमेव रत्नम एंड तस्य प्रभा the luster which is there hidden in the bhashya which itself is a gem that kind of vyakhya is called as bhashyaratna prabha vyakhya and this is studied because it is simpler. So initial study is bhashyaratna prabha because the other tikas are quite terse. On this there is a tika called as purnanandiya and in the vivarna sampradaya the vivarna itself is a tika on not directly on the bhashya. On bhashya there is panchapadika written by not written exactly, we can't say it was written later, but then it was created by Padmapadacharya, one of the four shishyas of Bhagavan Bhashyakara, and then on that there is a tika which is called as by Prakashatmiyati, which is called as vivarna, and that is what gives the name to the sampradaya, vivarna sampradaya. So I think this much background is enough. With this we'll directly delve into the tika and vyakhya on adhyasa bhashya, but adhyasa bhashya itself is an introduction to the brahma sutras. Brahma sutras are in are across four chapters, each chapter having four padas, four quarters. And the total number of sutras, adhikaranas, are sections which are groups of sutras which make up one unit. So they have a one unit of common topic. We'll see what makes a definition of an adhikarana. It's a bunch of sutras which vary in number. Across padas, the sutras vary in number. But padas are per chapter four, and there are four such chapters. The total number of sutras are 555. Adhikaranas are said to be 191 or 192 based on Patha Bheda. Nonetheless, that being so, I'll go through Purnanandiya section in not detail, but we'll see how much details we can go through in Bhashyaratna, Bhashyaratna Prabha, which is also called as Ratna Prabha because Bhashya itself is Ratna, so Ratna stands for the Bhashya itself. So I'll start with these prayers of Purnanandiya, and then we can do the prayers of the Bhashya Ratna, so Ratna Prabha. Yad Brahma Gochara Vichitratam of Prabhavat Samsara Dhijanita Dukkham Abhujanasya Yad Brahma Dhijanita Saukhyam Abhujatasya Tam Rukmini Saita Krishna Mahan Namami. So the Ishta Devata Namaskara is being done in this Mangalacharana of Purnanandiya. So what the Tikakara does there is he invokes his Ishta Devata Krishna, who is not alone, he is Rukmini Sahita. So he likes that form of Krishna who is with Rukmini. So Tam Rukmini Sahitam Krishnam Aham Namami. I worship, I bow down. So Nama is Pravhi Bhave. It is, bowing down to the Ishwara in a particular form. Here the particular form happens to be Krishna's form along with Rukmini, who is his in at the universal level. You talk about Ishwara with his Maya Shakti, and to that Krishna I bow down. So that this tika that I am creating, says the Acharya, that it gets completed and reaches the audience and has vistara, has a good reach, so that everyone is benefited. And what, who is that Krishna who is along with Rukmini? That is mentioned as Yad Brahma Gochara Vichitra Tamah Pravavat Samsaradhi Janita Dukkham Abhut Janasya. There is lot of Samsara Janita Dukkha. Samsaranam is transmigration, life of becoming something you are not. The Shuddha Swarupa of each and every Jiva is Brahma, Satchidananda Brahma, and that substratum, which is your real Swarupa, is also the adhishthana for avidya. So yad brahma, brahma atma, which is our own swarupa, yad brahma gochara, in that brahma which is there, what is there? There is avidya ajnana, which is resting upon that very same brahma atma, our own swarupa, which is also called as darkness, tamaha. So that tamaha, the influence of tama is such, and vichitra, it is so mind-boggling and varied that it creates this prapancha. Of course, with the adhishtana of Brahma, Satta, Spurti, Anantya of the Brahma Tattva, giving it reality as though to that Ajnana Avidya, which is not really existent, which is Mithya, which is inferred by the Karya. By its results, you can infer that there is Karana, because without Karana, you cannot have Karya, and that Karya is this Prapancha, Samsara, and with this Samsara Buddhi, that I am a Samsari, finding myself trapped in ups and downs of the world, thereby there is Dukkha. So this Dukkha is Janita from the Samsara Ji, which is an effect of the tama. So it is under the influence of tama, which is avidya, which is vichitra, and rests in Brahma. That Brahma is also sukharupa, anandarupa, which counters dukkha. So if ajnana is powerful, then it will veil the ananda in the swarupa. But once the jnana becomes powerful enough to take away, jnana of the adhishthana, of brahmatma, becomes powerful enough to counter the ajnana, which is not abhava rupa, it is bhava rupa, yat kinchit bhava rupa. That ajnana is countered by a stronger jnana, and when it is strong enough to destroy the yat kinchit bhava rupa jnana completely, then this brahma dhi will be manifesting as Brahmakara Vritti. Clearly, of course, Brahmakara Vritti itself is Vritti Rupa Jnana, which will counter the Ajnana, because Swarupa, Brahma Swarupa, has no opposition to anything. It lights up the Ajnana also as much as it lights up the Jnana. Thereby, when the Vritti Rupa Jnana, Brahmakara Vritti, takes place, that is mentioned here as Yad Brahmadhi Janita Saukhyam Abhuchya. And for people, this Sukha, when it takes place, Ananda manifests as Swarupa Ananda, not Vishaya Ananda. When all Vishaya Ananda is known to be only when the desire towards the Vishaya ceases and the Ananda of Swarupa manifests, when it is known that the source of Ananda is Brahmatma, my own Swarupa, there is no other Ananda, then one will stop hankering. One will stop having raga, dvesha, kama towards vishayas, and then the samsaranam will stop, which is moksha. So, yad brahma dhi janita saukhyam abhuchya, tasya rukmini sahita krishnam aham namami. So, this janasya, tasyeva janasya, this sukha is also for the same jana for whom there was dukkha initially in the samsara avastha. Now in mukti avastha, moksha avastha, there is ananda from the same source, which was the adhishthana for the dukkha karana avidya. And who is that? That Brahma is Rukmini Sahita Krishna, and to that manifest form Saguna Brahma, I do my namaskara, because Nirguna Brahma is my own swarupa. Very difficult to objectify it even in any way and do namaskara. Because as soon as you objectify, it has become saguna. You cannot objectify anything without guna. So nirguna brahma cannot be objectified. So even if I want to do namaskara, I have to manifest myself. I want to hold on to myself as jiva and do namaskara to my ishta devata, who is brahma swarupa. So that is the first sloka, and the similar idea continues in next sloka as yatpada padma bhajaneshu anurakta chittaha मोक्षंगता यदि दुरात्म जना किमन्ये यल्लीलया जगदभूत विविध स्वरूपम तम रुक्मिणी सहित कृष्णम हं नमामि. सो आई गो डाउन टू द सेम कृष्ण हु इज रुक्मिणी सहित अलोंग विथ रुक्मिणी हुज यत पाद पद्म भजनेशु अनुरक्त चित्ताः. सो दोज हु आर दोज ही अति दुरात्म जनः इवन दी अति दुरात्म जनः दोज हु आर दुष्टा इवन दोज काइंड ऑफ पीपल हु हैव बिकम अनुरक्त चित्ताः हुज चित्ता अंतकरण माइंड इज रिजॉइसिंग इन भजनास भजनेशु इन भजनास हुज भजनास यत्पाद पद्म हुज एवर लोटस फीट द फीट विच आर कंपेरेबल टू लोटस हु इज दैट रुक्मिणी सहित कृष्ण एंड अंटू हुज फीट अंटू द भजनास ऑफ हुज फीट इवन द अति दुरात्म जनाः Because of being anurakta chitta, anurakta chitta, bhajaneshu anurakta chitta is a hetu garbha visheshana to these patiduratma janaha, even they what? Mokshangataha. They attained moksha. They attained moksha. There is not something which will happen in some time in the future. It has always been so. Even the worst of the rakshasas having taken refuge unto Ishvara have got moksha. Kimanye is a rhetoric, it is a kaimutika nyaya as to what to speak about others. Others will obviously get moksha having taken refuge to Ishvara. Of course, paramparaya. In sequence, when chitta shuddhi is enough and jnana shravana fructifies. And whose leela? This entire thing is what? Yallilaya jagad abhud vivida swarupam. And that jagat karanatvam is also mentioned. The same ishta devata is jagat karana brahma, whose leela is the manifestation of this entire prapancha. It is a praise. It is an arthavada. The leela of Bhagavan as this world is refuted in Mandukya Karika. So it is not literal. It is a praise of the Lord that for you all this is leela. My suffering is real for me, but for you it is leela. My sukha is also real for me, but for you it is all leela. It is a play. So the easiness of creation is mentioned there. As a child plays with the toys, Bhagavan plays in manifesting the universe. So someone may ask, if this is all play, is my dukkha play to Ishvara? Not literally. He is giving what we deserve, what we wanted. So he is just a neutral karma phala data. Although he jagat karta, that jagat creation is in keeping with the intentions of the jivas which were there earlier. So whatever is due is given without any bias, whether it is sukha or dukkha. Thereby, it is not a leela literally. काशिकादेश विश्वेशं नमामि करुणानिधिं उमांग संगादनिशं पिशांग प्रकाशकम्. Now after doing Ishtadevata Namaskara, being a Kashi Vasi, most of these scholars were in Kashi, Varanasi. So he says Kashikadhisha. Kashika is Kashi. The Ishwar of Kashi is who? Vishvesha, Vishwanatha, Shiva. So tam Vishvesham Kashika Adhisha. He is Adidevata. He is the supreme ruler of Kashi, which is the knowledge center of the entire prapancha. To that Lord I do namaskara. Who is Karunanidhi? He is a treasure of compassion, not just compassion. He is a treasure of compassion. To that Shiva I do my namaskara now. Who is Anisha? Pishanga Prakasham. He is that supreme light, Chaitanya, and he is free from any flaws. He is flawless, Anisham. Flawless without tamah also you can interpret, and nisha is night. So where does he get this luster from? So this source is mentioned as being ardhanarishara, umanga sanga, because he has sanga of umanga, the part of umanga, the ardha nari is making him complete. So that is the devotion of the Purnanandiyakara towards Parvati also, Devi also, and thereby this Shiva has become Anisha. And you can also take poetically as, because Parvati is with him, his luster is her beauty, her luster, her beauty keeps him awake. The next shloka says, Yasya smritirapi cha shishya jana bhavanti kamadi dosha rahita yati shuddha chittaha yadhyanatah paramakarana susthiraste tam shri gurum paramahamsa yatin namami yo drishyate yammiti satya chidatmakatma shishyadi punya paripaka vashadi danim chidyoga dharinam majasra majam smitasyam tam shri gurum paramahamsa yatin namami. So the next two verses are Namaskara to the Guru. Which Guru? He is Shri Guru, he is Shri Yukta Guru, who is a Paramahamsa, Paramahamsa Sanyasi. Yasya Smritirapi, and what is the Mahima of this Guru? Even by recalling, you know, we say the Guru is Pratasmaraniya. So Pratasmaraniya Guru, the Guru is recalled in the early morning, so that your day goes well towards progress, you know, the progress towards moksha is much by recalling the Guru. So yasya smritirapi, even by just recollection of the Guru, shishya janaha, the entire group of shishyas, all the shishyas, bhavanti, they become what? Kamadi dosha rahita, hi ati chuddha chitta. So they become free from all the doshas in the form of kama, kamadi. So the triad is said to be avidya, kama, karma. So kama manifests in the antakkarana as raga, dvesha, adi emotions, which are doshas, and they lead to karma, which lead to karma phala, which is binding. Thereby the person who is a karta remains as a bhokta, is bound, is forced to be a bhokta, and to become a bhokta he has to take janma again and again. But recollecting Guru, the shishyas themselves become bereft of kamadi doshas, and thereby atishuddha chitta, their antakkarana becomes nirmala just by the smriti of Guru, and thereby yadhyanataha, and having dhyana on that kind of a Guru, chintana or even meditation on that Guru, paramakaruna susthiraste. One becomes, sorry, I've got a throat irritation, sorry. So, paramakarana susthira aste. So, one, the Guru himself is the paramakarana Ishvara. There is no difference between Ishvara and Guru. And the Shishya becomes that Brahma, Brahma Veda, Brahma Iva Bhavati, therefore becomes a paramakarana, remains in that sushtu sthira, he becomes sthira in that paramakarana Brahma, because the dhyana is on Guru, and the meditating shishya is said to become sthira, his dhyana becomes sthira, resolves, he gets samadhi in whom? In that Guru. But it has not mentioned as he gets samadhi in Guru, he gets samadhi in paramakarana, he becomes susthira, sushtu sthira in paramakarana Brahma, the cause of all causes, which is causeless. So, karana rahita karana brahma, who is nothing but Guru, because by saying that, having done dhyana on the Guru, if one is getting samadhi in paramakarana brahma, then Guru is paramakarana brahma. That is implied here, tam shri gurum paramahamsam yatim namami. Further, yaha drishyate ayamiti satya chidatmak atma. So the Atma व्हाट काइंड ऑफ आत्मा दृश्यते, यह दृश्यते, यह सत्य चित आत्मा, आत्मा हियर इज स्वरूप, देन सेकंड आत्मा इज द रियल आत्मा, सो हियर आत्मा अर्लियर फर्स्ट वर्ड आत्मा इज इन द सेंस ऑफ स्वरूप, नॉट स्वरूप एज इन आत्मस्वरूप, स्वरूप एज इन द लिटरल वर्ड स्वरूप, स्वभाव. सो सत्यम एंड चित, सत्यम च चित च, सत्यम च तत् चित च कर्मधारय, इट इज द सेम सत्य एंड चित विच इज ब्रह्म. सो सत्य चित आत्मा स्वरूपम यस्य आत्मनः, सह आत्मा सत्य चिदात्मकः, सो इट्स अ बहुरी, यू कैन सी द कप प्रत्यय हियर. सो दैट आत्मा विच इज माय स्वरूप रियली, व्हाट इज इट्स रियल स्वरूप, सत्य चित सच्चित. एंड हाउ डू आई नो अयम इति दृश्यते, सो आई कैन मेक आउट हु इज इट, अयम, अयम इज mentioned here not as an object but as the very swarupa I know closest to me. Who is closest to me? I am the closest to me. Antakkarana is away, the sharira is further away, all the koshas are further away, withdrawn from me. So ayam iti meaning in the buddhi which shines as ayam, as aham really, that atma is my swarupa. Yah drishyate ayam iti, when? Idanim, now. And why does it shine forth now? Why does my own swarupa shine forth now? Shishyadi punya paripaka paripaka vashad. Because it's an effect of shuddhi, chitta shuddhi. Chitta shuddhi of whom? Shishya. And just by being the shishya of that kind of a guru who is Brahma, I have got chitta shuddhi, and thereby the shravana from the guru is shining forth as my own swarupa. This Brahma is shining forth as my own swarupa now, idani. And chidyoga dharanam ajasram ajam. Who is that Brahma Atma? Paramahamsa Shri Guru. He is Aja. And now this is in the Dvitiya Vibhakti, being karma in the Kartari Prayoga, aham namami. Aham Shri Gurum Paramahamsam Hamsa Yatintam namami. Who is what? Ajam. Who is Aja? So when you translate in English, you know, if you say Ajam, here Ajam is neuter, it's okay, but then Paramahamsa Yati is not neuter. Aja can be neuter. But here Aja is in keeping with Shri Guru who is Pullinga. Therefore, Aja becomes Ajam in Dvitiya Vibhakti. So these mistakes will be there when I say Ajam Namami, or if I say, you know, I bow down to Ajam. It should be, I bow down to Aja. But then these are the flaws when you translate across languages where you don't have this kind of a linga bheda. Chidyoga dharinam ajasram ajam. So satatam. Ajasram means satatam sada. I, who is ever unborn, to him I am always bowing down to. Who is chidyoga dharinam? Who is always in samadhi with that Chaitanya Swarupa, who is always merged in that samadhi, or who is always merged in his own Swarupa, even when he is interacting with the Shishya Varga or in the world, he is always in that Sahaja Samadhi because it is his own Swarupa. He is never away from it. To that kind of Guru, I do my Namaskara. That's the fifth verse. Shat shastra parina dhurina shishyer yuktam sada brahma vichara shilaihi advaita vani charanabja yugmam mukti padam tat pranatosmi nityam. So again, pranatosmi nityam. Adi kartariktaha. So this is a kartariktaha. Pranatasmi. Aham pranatasmi. Nityam pranatasmi. Adi kartari is in sense of the namaskara has started. Prakarsha namaskara has started, but it has not stopped. It is continuing. It is continuously going on. I always bow down to my guru, says he. Tat pranatasmi. And who is that? Advaita vani charanabja yugmam. So, it is the guru's padma, which is in the form of lotus. Pada, which is form of padma. So, abja yugmam. The pair I bow down to. And which is what? It is a praise of the Guru, Advaita Vani, the Advaita, which the namaskara is to the feet, whose feet, where there is Advaita Vani, which is what Mukti Pradam, Prakarshena Dadati. This Mukti is not like other Muktis like Sayujya Mukti, you know, Salokya, Sarupya Mukti. It is not that kind of Mukti. This Mukti is Prakarsha, Prakarshena Dadati. These very feet of the Guru, why are his teaching? I bow down because I want the teaching, and that teaching, Shravana, makes me free. It is Mukti Pradam. Prakarshena Dadati. So it gives me Mukti which will not go away. It is Nitya Mukti. It is not Anitya Mukti like Sarupya Salokya Mukti, whereby my Punya exists and then I come down to Martya Loka. It is not that kind of Mukti. So therefore, Pra is added here. Pradam. Prakarshena Dadati. Shat Shastra Parina, and this Guru is praised that he is an expert in all Shastras and endowed with Shishya Varga. He is never free from Shishyas. People flock to learn from that Guru, and who is always what the Brahma Vichara Shilaihi Shishyaihi. He is flocked by Shishyas. Which kind of Shishyas? Not these Shishyas who want some miracles or something. They want Mukti, and they are themselves, you know, Shishyas are also praised. Those kind of Shishyas, they themselves, the Shishyas are praised here as, because it is not the Guru. Shat Shastra Parina Dhurina Shishyaihi Brahma Vichara Shilaihi Yuktam. This Guru is praised by saying his Shishyas themselves are experts in six Shastras, and who have become experts due to this teaching into Brahma Vichara. Always, Sada. Sutra Bhashya Kritau Natva Yati Shrestan Guru Napi Abhivyakta Abhida Vyakhya Kriyate Buddhi Shuddhaye. Then, the Tikakara says, Sutra Bhashya Kritau Natva, having done Namaskara to Sutra Karta and Bhashya Krita. Krita here is in the sense of Karta. Kartarikta again. So, Bhagavan Badarayana Vyasa, who is Sutra Karta, Brahma Sutra Karta, and Bhagavan Bhashyakara Adi Shankaracharya, who is Bhashyakarta, having done Namaskara to them, who are Gurus, who taught me what they taught, he does Namaskara to those Gurus also. Yati Shrestan Guru Napi. And his Gurus were all Yatis. They were all, or it can be even a single Guru who is praised and who with respect is bowed down and addressed in plural. So it is a Sampradaya. Yati Shrestan, and not Paramahamsa. So Yati Shrestha is a Paramahamsa, the best of the sannyasis, not Veshadhari sannyasis. Not all those who wear ochre are sannyasis, they don't have sannyasa vritti, but those who have taken sannyasa for moksha and stay the course, they are Yati Shrestas. Abhivyakta Abhida Vyakhya. So this Vyakhya, which manifests the Bhashya clearly, that kind of Bhashya I create. And why do I create this Vyakhya? Not Bhashya, Vyakhya on the Bhashya. Why do I create? Buddhi Shuddhaye. So my purpose is not fame or anything, says the author. He says it is for my own Chitta Shuddhi. Ratna Prabha, then Ratna Prabha Duruhancha Vyakaromi Yathamati Dhi Kritana Mita Doshan Kshamadvam Vibudhamama. And then he says that there will be flaws here. Knowingly or unknowingly, some flaws will have crept in. Even that kind of scholar says that Kshamadvam Vibudhamama. So please forgive my mistakes. He says, O Vibudhaha, He Vibudaha, Bho Vibudaha, those who have Vishesha Buddhi, unlike me, those who are free from samsara, who have Panditya also, if they go through this, please forgive my mistake, says he in the last Mangalacharana. He is saying, Ratna Prabha Duruham, Cha Vyakaromi. So I create this, which may be terse at places because I am trying to clarify what is there in the Bhashya in keeping with my Buddhi. So I can't, I have my own limitations being limited by this buddhi of a human intellect. Buddhi, which is a human intellect, limits me of how much I can describe. So if there are mistakes, or you know, if it gets terse, you know, you overlook these, says the author. Dhi krita, dhi kritan amitan doshan. And what should you forgive? He says amitan, immeasurable doshas are there. He says, if I had enough buddhi, I would have not made these doshas, but they have crept in because my buddhi is limited. This is the humility of the author. So you can imagine where we are in comparison. So with that, let's go to the Bhashyaratna Prabha, where the Mangalacharana of the Bhashyaratna Prabhakara, Ramananda Yati, Bhagavan Ramananda Yati, says, Yamiha Karunikam Sharanam Gato Apyarisahodara Apamahat Padam Tamahamashu Harim Paramashtraye Janaka Jangamananta Sukhakritim. So he says, Tam, Aham Tam Ashraye. So that is the main part of the Mangalacharana, as I bow down to him. Who is that? Who is Iha in this samsara bhumi? Iha yam karunikam sharanam gataha api. Api means, api will connect with Ari Sahodara api. So Ari Sahodara, Ari is Rakshasa Ravana, and is Sahodara. Sahodara is who is born in the same udara, in the same womb, meaning the brother or sister, but here is Pullinga. So who is Ravana's brother? Vibhishana. So even the Rakshasa's brother, Sahodara, so the udara is same. So he is born in the same womb as Ravana, who turned out to be Rakshasa, but Vibhishana was not a Rakshasa, even in the Rakshasa Kutumba maybe, but even being so, Ari Sahodara api Mahat Padam Apa, he attained Mahat Pada. He attained the Lanka Samrajya, that is the Mahat Pada. He attained Moksha also. How? By taking resort to Sharanam Gataha, by taking refuge unto whom? The Parama Karunika. Here Karunikam, one who is compassionate, Rama, unto him. So taking refuge unto Rama, even the Ravana's brother Vibhishana attained Mahatpada. Apa. Apa is a Tingantapada. It is the verb. So Mahatpadam Apa. Yam Karunikam Sharanam Gataha Ari Sahodara Api Mahatpadam Apa Tam Aham Ashu Ashraye. Harim. Hari is, there is no Bheda between Rama and Hari. The Hari, Vishnu Narayana, manifested, had took an avatara as Rama. So unto that Hari, I take refuge myself, because I also want mukti. So tam parama harim, paramashraye. So you can say paramashraye, param ashraye. This param is harim, that Hari who is the most superior. And when will I take refuge? Now. Ashraye is latlakar, I am doing it now. But immediately, Ashu is quickly I do that, because as soon as I know that even the Rakshasa Vibhishana gets mukti by taking refuge into Rama, I should not waste any time, I should immediately take refuge into Rama. So that's what he says, Param Harim Aham Ashraye, Ashu Ashraye, immediately. Who is that Hari? So do not get confused, he says, he is my Ishta Devata, Janaka Jangam. So Janaka Ja. Janaka Jata Ya Sita, Mata Sita. So that's Janaka Ja Sita Ankeyasya, who is by whose side? So that Sita is by whose side? Born of Janaka. Who is by whose side? Rama's side. So he is Janaka Janka. Tam Janaka Jankam Harim Param Harim Param Aham Ashraye. And why do I do that? Of course, I want Mahatpada Mukti, which is what? Ananta Sukhakritim. So Mahatpada also is Ananta Sukhakriti, but really Anandamurti is Rama himself, who became Krishna as the Ananda Murti also, so Ananda Sukhakruti, whose Akruti is Sukhakruti, Akruti here is in sense of Swarupa. So I want that Mahatpada which is Anandatmaka by taking refuge into Hari who is Anandatmaka, who is Sukhakruti. So that is the first shloka. There is Tika on this which explains this. I have already explained. So Iha means Iha Vyavahara Bhuma Vityartha. On this Vyavahara Bhumi. Avatara was here. So we saw all these things happening here. We know all these things have happened here through Itihasa, through Ramayana. Apishabda, Apishabda se Vyutkramena Anvaya. So the Apishabda connects with not as Api Sahodara, but as not as Api Ari Sahodara, but Ari Sahodara Api. Ari Sahodara Api, who is that? Vibhishana. And what is the Mahatpada that he achieved? Moksha Lanka Samrajya Rupam Mahatpadam Apa. Which is in the form of Moksha. Or at least Laukika you have to take as Lanka Samrajya. He became the king of Lanka as a Laukika Phala. So, Bhukti Mukti Pradata. Rama has given him Lanka Samrajya Bhukti also and Moksha Mukti also. That kind of Mahatpada Apa Prapta Abhuz. He attained that. Who is that? Vibhishana, who is Ari Sahodara. Abhuditi Kriya Karaka Yojana. This is how the Anvaya is, how the words connect. Ananta Sukhakriti Mityanena Swarupa Lakshanam Itarena Tatastha Lakshanam Chauktamiti Bhavaha. So by saying Ananta Sukhakriti, by saying this limitless Sukha, Ananda, which is not experienceable. So it is not something that you can experience. What you experience is all that. But you cannot experience because you cannot objectify that. You are in that Swarupa. So that I objectify in Rama. So that is mentioned here. Ananda Sukhakruti Mityanena Swarupa Lakshana. Swarupa Lakshana. Whereas Tatastha Lakshana is Jagat Karta. That is on the boundary. It is not the real Swarupa. But it is through which you can land on the Swarupa. So Tatastha Lakshana is like, you know, somebody points out a house where the common example given is crow is sitting on the house. So Tatastha is Tatetishtati. It is on the banks. It is not exactly the river. You point out to the bank saying this is the river. So similarly, you point out to the house on which the, so if somebody asks which is Devadatta's house, this is Devadatta's house where you see the crow sitting. The crow is incidental. It is not part of the, of Devadatta's house. But it helps you land on Devadatta's house, which is the real Swarupa intended. Therefore, it is Tatastha Lakshana, this Jagat Karana, Brahma, Sagunatvam is all Tatastha. The Swarupa Lakshana is mentioned as Ananta Sukhakrutim. Everything else, the grace of Rama is all mentioned as Sagunatvam. It is all Tatastha Lakshana. Shri Gaurya Sakalarthadam Nijapadam Bhojena Mukti Pradam Praudham Vignavanam Harantamanagam Shri Dundi Tundasina Vande Charma Kapalikopakarnair Vairagya Saukhyat Param Nasti Iti Pradishantamanta Viduram Shri Kashikesham Shivam. Again, being in Kashi, he does Namaskara after Ishta Devata Namaskara to Kashikesha Vishwanath Shiva. So he says, Vande, Aham Vande, I bow down to whom? Shri Kashikesha Shiva. And who uses Karanas? Karanas, who uses for various results, he uses other deities. So he himself, he being Ishvara, manifests as others, but then if you look at his Kutumba, what is his Kutumba? He has Shri Gauri, okay, Mata Parvati on his side. He has Shri Dundi. Dundi is a rudier word for Ganesha. Who has a Tunda, who has a trunk, which itself is Asi. It behaves like a sword. So anyway, these are his tools to get the result that the Shishya wants. And he himself is Charma Kapalika Upakaranaihi. He is himself not having a lot of wealth. What does he have? he has a skin. He wears an elephant skin, they say. And then Kapalika, he is in Smashana, so what will be he surrounded with? He is like a Bhikshuka, he has himself does not need anything. So he has a Kapala, he has the skull. And these are his Upakaranas. And with that, what is he showing? He is showing that Vairagya Saukhyat Param Nasti. So other than Vairagya Sukha, there is no other Sukha. In the Taittiriya Upanishad, Ananda Mimamsa, you see this. So one who has Vairagya towards the highest Sukha possible in a particular Deha, Upadhi, he gets 100 times Sukha of the of that Upadhi. So there is a there is a hierarchy of Sukha mentioned, and the highest Sukha is Hiranyagarbha Sukha, which is 10 raised to 20 times the human Sukha, not a regular human, an ideal human, which is theoretical. A human being who is an emperor of the entire universe, the entire world's wealth is at his disposal. He owns it. And he is dharmika. So it is not that he is getting sensual sukha, which is going to wear and tear his sense organs and his sharira. But he is dharmika. He is shrotriya. And he is young. He is young enough to enjoy the sukha. That kind of an ideal person, if he is one unit of sukha, is manishya sukha, manishya ananda, then what would be the ananda of, 10 raised to 20 kind of ananda of that Hiranyagarbha. And this is all you can objectify, but it is still, limited. Ananta sukha is your own swarupa. So if you have vairagya unto any of these, then you will get 100 times that sukha. Meaning, finally, you will land on Swarupa Sukha. That is the intention of the Ananda Mimamsa there. And this is shown here as Vairagya Saukhyat Param Sukham Nasti. There is no other Sukha compared to Vairagya Sukha, because Vishaya Sukha is all Swarupa Ananda. You give that up, the Swarupa Ananda starts manifesting, which is finally what you have been hunting for, because every other Sukha is Anitya. This is Nitya Sukha. So what is he achieving by all of these, by his side or in his kutumba? Shri Gaurya Sakalarthadam. So he becomes one who is giving all artha. He himself has nothing. He has vairagya unto everything. And that's why he has ananta ananda. But that Shiva blesses the shishya with artha, sakalartha. Whatever the shishya wants, he gives. He gave everything that Ravana wanted as well. So you can, that's why you call him, in Hindi they say Bhola, Bhole Shiva Baba. So that Sakalarthadam Shivam Aham Vande, and how does he become Sakalarthadam? He uses Shri Gauri for that, because she is the Shri Swarupa herself. She can give you anything that you want, so he asks, through her he gives. He does not give directly. He is free from all of this. So if the bhaktas are interested, then he gives all artha. Sakalarthan dadati tam sakalarthadam aham namami. Aham vande. And through whom? Shri Gaurya. This tritiya. Then nijapadam bhojena mukti pradam. What does he himself give? Before that, Praudham Vignavanam Harantam Anagham. He is also what? He is Haranta. He is one who is going to take away, Shiva is going to take away the entire set of Vignas. So Vignavana, the forest of Vignas, obstacles, he is going to take away. How? It is also Prauda. It is, very dense kind of a forest of Vigna. He is going to take away. He himself is anaga. He is himself is untainted by any of these obstacles. He is paparahita and free from obstacles also. But he is going to take away all of this. How? Through the Vignaharta. So he himself takes away, but through Ganesha. So Shri Dunditundasina. Through the sword of the trunk of Shri Ganesha, which is unique. That is the main, or Tunda can also be seen as Mukhya. So he is the leader of that army which will take away your entire Prouda Vignavana. And thereby Shiva becomes, you know, Vignavana Hara or Haranta. And by himself, what does he give you? Without using any of them, by himself, he is Mukti Prada. He will give you Mukti Prada. And this we have seen in the Mangalacharana of the Tikakara also. So these ideas have come from the earlier shloka also. The Mangalacharana shloka is there in the in some form in the Tikakara's Mangalacharana also. So he says, Nija Padam Bhojena. The lotus feet, through the lotus feet, he gives Mukti by himself. And what does he show? Vairagi Saukyat Param Nasti Iti Pradishantam. He is teaching by living that Vairagi life. He shows that he is Mukti Prada. He takes away Vigna through Ganesha. And he gives everything that the Shishya wants, disciples want through Shri Gauri. That kind of Antaviduram. Shri Kashikesham Shivam Aham Vande. So I do Namaskara, I worship that Shiva who is Antaviduram Antarahitam. So we'll see the Tika on this in the next part. I will stop here. Yamiha Karunikam Sharanam Gatopyari Sahodara Apamat Padam Tamam Ashu Harim Paramashri Janaka Jangam Ananta Sukakritim Om Tat Sat. I hope there are no questions today. I'll see you in the next part. Huh? Namaste.
Namaste. Namaste.